In this video, we'll discuss some extra considerations for programming Experiment Builder projects. First, we'll discuss how to set the transparency color property, which can lead to image and text degradation if not properly set. Then, we'll talk about two options for getting online feedback on the host PC monitor during experimental sessions. All Experiment Builder projects have a property called transparency color. You can set the value of this transparency color in the Devices tab of the Structure panel under the Display section, or by going to Edit, Preferences, Display. The transparency color is a red, green, blue, or RGB value corresponding to a particular color that will be made transparent for all display screen actions. This feature can be used to do things like green screen effects and superimposed images, and it allows for some quite useful effects in some projects. This project does not exploit this feature, as it just involves simple presentation of images. Whether you are exploiting this transparency color feature or not, it should always be set to a value that is similar to, but not exactly the same as, the background color that you are using in your display screen actions. In this case, the background color of our display screen actions is 153, 153, 153, so we have set the transparency color to 152, 152, 152. Next, during eye movement recording, it's nice to see a representation of what the participant is viewing on the display PC in the section of the host PC monitor that represents the display PC monitor. We can have Experiment Builder transfer one display screen action of the recording sequence's contents to the host PC to use as a backdrop behind the gaze cursor so that we can monitor where the participant is looking during the trials. To do so, we need to do two things. First, we need to make sure that the prepare sequence action in the trial sequence has its draw to iLink host property set to image. Second, we need to then select one display screen action in the recording sequence and check its use for host display property. We should then make sure all other display screen actions have their use for host display property unchecked, as the host PC can only display one static image during the trial. Note, this limitation does not apply to visualizing the data in Data Viewer after data has been collected. In Data Viewer, you can see all of the trial stimuli that this participant saw in its trial animation playback view and in the spatial overlay view. Finally, Experiment Builder has the ability to send a message to the experimenter for each trial of the project. The iLink record status message property of the recording sequence is responsible for sending the message to the experimenter. In this project, our message gives feedback telling the experimenter the current trial number and how many trials are in the project in total. This message uses string concatenation and references to the iteration and iteration count property of the trial sequence to create a string that contains the properly formatted message text. The message will be presented at the bottom right corner of the host PC monitor during data recording. This message is not required by the Experiment Builder project, but it's a nice thing to include.